Let's talk about building private agentic flows. Now, these aren't just chatbots. These are agents that can reason, take action, and still keep your data completely private. Let's explore what private actually means and why it's incredibly important for building with AI. So let's imagine we are healthcare developers, right? We want to use AI to summarize medical docs or craft an email based on a patient's recent visit. We can take those docs and we can take our notes and we can send them to a consumer-facing web application that fronts one of the big gen AI platforms and get back really decent results. Now, obviously, do not do this. But there is another huge problem besides the obvious. You'd be sending protected healthcare info to a third party without proper safeguards, violating HIPAA. And you really don't want to do that. And if you're in finance, legal, or defense, just like healthcare, these public API endpoints are usually off the table. Agentic AI is incredible. But if you're working with sensitive data, consumer-facing LLMs and public APIs are a deal breaker due to privacy concerns. So, how exactly do we use the power of agentic AI in these applications? The answer is private agentic flows, where the agents that act on your behalf are keeping your data behind your firewall. In the next few minutes, I will tell you what makes an agent private, some of the architecture behind these systems, and maybe a few practical steps to start building your own private agents. Let's first quickly go over what we mean by agentic AI. The LLMs of the past, and realistically that's like last year, were fundamentally reactive and relatively simple. You ask a question and they respond. But now we have agents and they can reason, they can act on your behalf. They can do all these complex tasks. But if you're still using LLMs that are connected to the public cloud, you cannot work with sensitive data. So what is a private agentic flow? Let's think of it in three layers. Our first layer is going to be the foundation layer. And this is where our LLMs would run, right? It doesn't matter if it's closed source or open source, it just matters where they run. Your model must run entirely on your infrastructure, whether on-prem or in a private cloud environment. Then there's the augmentation layer. And this is where we could have our REC, or we could have our VectorDB, or we could have our fine-tuned adapters. Your agent retrieves info from your private knowledge bases or your document repositories to ground its responses with your specific and private data. And finally, we have our action layer, right? Now, this is where the tools and the APIs that your agent needs to use in order to function will live. So when it makes a call to your DB, or when it does anything or creates any kind of information that it needs for you, this is where it's going to live. But just because we're behind a firewall does not remove all potential risks, right? Think about when you fine-tune an LLM, and you're using private data. That information is embedded into your model. So even though your model is private and behind your firewall, that data that's inside there, if someone gets access, they could potentially extract it. Next, and this is a big one, is regulations, right? GDPR, HIPAA, they each have different requirements. Compliance with requests to remove personal data is a pretty complex task when data is embedded in a model. There are some techniques that can extract it and remove it, but they are imperfect and they are still evolving. And finally, we have insider threats, right? And it's not necessarily that someone's trying to do something bad, but they might misuse the system or accidentally expose data. So how can we resolve this? First, the data that we're training the model on, you can anonymize it, right? That's big. You just scrub any PII before it ever touches your LLM. Replace names with tokens or hashes, remove identifiers, strip out anything that could trace back to a real person. Make your data anonymous from the get-go. Second, access control. Implement strong access controls. Not every single person needs to touch your system, right? Log every prompt, log every interaction, every query, every retrieval. This will create compliance trails and ensure only those who absolutely need to touch the data can touch the data. And finally, data minimization. Only give your agents access to the minimum data they need for their specific tasks. Don't give your appointment scheduling agent access to full medical histories when it only needs the patient's names and when they're available. So this isn't just theoretical. Devs are building these private agents in the most regulated industries on Earth. Like we mentioned before, healthcare, right? Developers in healthcare are building agents to help doctors summarize patient histories, craft emails, track statuses. The agent retrieves data from electronic health records and references medical research, but the data never leaves the network. And then we have financial services. Teams at banks are building their agents for fraud detection, customer service, where they analyze transactions, flag anomalies, use customer data, and that all must stay within their secure infrastructure. And then we have legal. Developers at law firms are building agents to search case law, draft contracts, and identify relevant precedents from private case databases. And once again, it stays within their network. And finally, and probably the most regulated, is gov and defense, right? If you're working with intelligence or defense, you need these agents to analyze classified documents or connect dots across data sources, and consumer LLM services aren't even considered. Private agentic systems are the only option here. Now, these developers and teams know the value of agents, and they had to find a way to implement them. Private agentic flows are a necessity if you're building applications that handle sensitive data. And as AI becomes more integrated into sensitive and critical workflows, the questions will not be, should we go private, but rather, how quickly can we get there?